And Juan Enrique is quite an act to follow, so I'll do my best. So let's talk about huge problems. Our civilization is totally dependent on finite resources of coal, oil, and natural gas. We burn them, we flow them through chemical refineries and factories, and they produce almost everything that we use. This is unsustainable, and this is very dangerous. A radical solution will be to harness the power of biology, because living things can use renewable resources, such as sugars, sunlight, and CO2, and they are versatile enough and can produce almost everything we currently get from fossil fuels. And the best thing about living things is that they can scale to meet our global challenges. And we can design living things, we can program them, because biology is just another information technology. So take computers, for example. Computers understand code, binary ones and zero. But you don't write computer software by typing ones and zero. You use abstraction layers. You use tools to design, debug, and compile your code into executables that runs on computers. Living things also understand code. They understand the A, C, T, and G of DNA. The executables are chromosomes and genomes that runs inside of biological computers, inside of cells. But genetic designers still write with ones and zero. People in my lab still write with A, T, G, and C. They don't have the design tool. They don't have the compile and debug tool that we have in software. They don't have a genome compiler. So we believe that the breakthrough technology is to create those tools that will enable the design and creation of useful living things to solve our global challenges. And we can do that because there is two underlying technologies that power this new field of synthetic biology: reading DNA and writing DNA. And both of those technologies, the price performance has been going down faster than Moore's law for the past 10 years. So Juan talked about reading DNA, where the price has been falling down from $3 billion to read one human genome to this year, 2012, $1,000. So as the price has been falling down so rapidly, our databases exploded with genetic information, with genes and genomes, nature's own software designs. But the really cool thing, the really cool technology is being able to write DNA, because now we can write our own software using whatever genetic code that we want. And we can turn our code into life by injecting it into living cells, and then use the cell machinery, this nanomachine, the self-assembled nanomachine that was developed in 4 years of evolution, to read our code, as you can see here on the left, RNA polymerase running on the genome, transcribing the gene into the yellow RNA molecule. And then on the right, using different cell machinery, the ribosome, to read this RNA molecule 3 letters at a time and translating it into protein, into flesh and blood. So those are amazing machines that we could never develop by ourselves. I think that it's just like giving iPads to cavemen. You can maybe play Angry Birds, but you could never build the chips behind it. It's amazing technology. And this is not science fiction. In 2002, scientists has created the first synthetic creature. It was a poliovirus, 7,500 letters. That's it. But think about it. You can now go to the internet, download the whole viral genome, and boot it up. That's very interesting. And then a year and a half ago, as Juan mentioned, the Craig Venter Institute has chemically synthesized 1 million base pair bacterial genome and booted up. So the first living cell. And then just a few months ago, scientists from the Johns Hopkins University have synthesized the first eukaryotic chromosome, 2.3 million base pair of a yeast chromosome. Our capability is just increasing. And if this trend continues, who knows what we'll be able to produce in the near future. And I believe we should be able to construct any genome that we like. It's obvious to me. So how do you go about designing living things? Well, we believe it should be as easy as just logging into a website. So this is what we are building right now. If you want to look for a genome, it should be as easy as searching for it or just browsing through genomes of bacterial and viruses. For example, I want to work on this E. coli. Just press on the icon, download it directly from the databases. And then if I want to manipulate it, just drag it into the canvas, and that's it. Now, this is just an icon, just a layer of abstraction. But we can present real genetic information. For example, the genome properties, the number of genes, the length of the genome. and what this genome knows to do, the metabolic pathway. Now, this diagram might look complex, but it's pretty simple. Every circle is a molecule that this bacteria knows how to produce, break down, or get from the environment. And every line is an enzyme that turns one of the circles, one of those molecules, to the next. And once we read the whole genome and populate this kind of diagram, then just like Google Map, we can start asking for direction. So let's say I want to go from glucose, simple sugar, and produce biofuel, methanol, for example. So I'm just asking, well, what's the shortest route? So in this case, the shortest route contains 8 genes. In white are the genes that are native in the genome. They are already there. But to close the circle from glucose to methanol, I need to add the genes in red and orange. They are not there, but we can give you candidates. And all you need to do is just select from a list of creatures. And you can select by closest evolutionary partners or three other criteria and just export them and compile them. Now, this is the hardest thing that we are doing. How do you run program from one creature in another? You need to optimize the code. You need to change the regulatory elements. So we started to build that. And as computer and it gets better, as we know more basic science, our algorithms will get better. Another thing that Juan showed is how you can start building complex systems starting with small elements. So that should be as easy as starting a new project, going back to the material box and searching for those elements, like a promoter that tells you, start reading this gene from here, ribosome binding site, a gene, a terminator saying, stop reading this gene. So in a few clicks, I created a whole genetic circuit, a whole small genetic circuit. If I want to learn more, just go to the tool panel and, hey, what does this gene does? So for here, I get the gene properties. If this protein has an experimentally solved structure, I can zoom into the structure. And if I know what I'm doing, in this case, it's a DNA binding protein. I can zoom into the structure, select amino acid, delete them, mutate them, change them, do some very cool structural-based changes. Now, everything I showed you so far is just icons. It's just layer of abstractions. So how do you go about moving from one layer to the next? Well, we believe it should be as easy as zooming in. So now we moved from this layer to the amino acid layer. And in the background, you can see the source code, the DNA. And in each layer, we can do different things. For example, in this layer, if you want to change the protein, just press an amino acid, get the code, change the code. That's it. You can save it. You'll be prompt. You can save. You'll be prompt to give your username and password because we keep track on your previous designs. And if you pay attention, your previous designs are just icons. It could be a very complicated design, which we represent in the simple icons. And you can share this icon with your friends. You can put it in our biological app store so other people can use and install your designs. If you want to get the DNA, just drag it to the cart, and we'll ship it to you. And then minimize it, and here is your new app. If you want to install your app in this bacteria, just search for a specific location and zoom in through the layer of abstraction until you find what you're looking for. And then, once you find the gene you're looking for, it should be as easy as dragging into the trash, getting your new app, and putting it in. That simple. Save, order, and that's it. Now, as you can see, ordering a whole genome, even at 25 cents a base pair, is pretty expensive. But the price of small genetic elements is reasonable right now, and it's going down very fast. So it's as easy as that. Press and order. Now, everything I showed you so far is how a person like myself, a trained biologist in a research laboratory, can do some very accurate and powerful genetic engineering using tools like that. But part of our vision is to get the tinkerers involved, to democratize the tools of creation. You know, get the do-it-yourself biologist involved. And what about the future of sustainability? Some people think that this might be the future, electric cars or solar-powered LED lamps. But we think that you can mash those together. And maybe in the future, you should be one of you can search for any element, any life form that you like. I like trees. I like oak trees very much. So let me go to the biological app store. Let me take the luminescence program from fireflies and just compile it into my app. And here I get renewable, self-assembled, solar-powered, sustainable street lamp for my, you know, home and community, and just order it. So you might think this is science fiction, but let me remind you, we can build cells today. This is not science fiction, right? And a tree started with a cell. You and I started with one cell. And this is beautiful, this is complex, but this is just software. It's software that writes its own hardware, but it's just software. And as the price of reading this software goes down, as we understand more and more about this software, with tools like us and with the constant ability to create more and more complex structures, we believe that anything will be possible moving forward. We live in this beautiful living world. Our world has a huge problem. Our current way of manufacturing is unsustainable. Living things can help us if you can just design them and compile them and create them. And then in the future, we might have a future of abundance, of sustainable abundance in a designed, engineered living world. Thank you.
Let us define X. X is a solution to a seemingly insurmountable problem, like climate change or cancer, one that affects the world. But what if we redefine X as a challenge, an opportunity for radical thinking, a chance to light up the world with breakthrough ideas and cutting-edge technology, the stuff of science fiction that just might fly after all? Solving for X requires wonder and imagination and the vision to build seemingly impossible solutions to the world's biggest problems. Solve for X. Moonshot thinking.